Hello world. The question is in the room. Will Godot one day achieve to be the number one game engine in the game engine industry? Well, it certainly looks like Godot is about to enter a golden age, as the hype around the game engine is only increasing by the day, right? If we follow the breadcrumbs of the posts and opinions on the internet, Godot is exploding in popularity and is rapidly overtaking Unity. Unity is still the biggest fish in the pond, but the question is, for how long will this stay true? And the whole reason for this crazy debate are some graphs shared by the GMTK Game Jam, one of the bigger game jams that are held every year. They share data on the engine which the submitted games were made with, and the amount of submitted games only grows each year. As we can see, Unity has always been the biggest slice of this pie, but the submissions through the Godot engine suddenly exploded this year, going up to 37% of all games submitted, and Unity has only 6% more submissions with 43%. Looking at this in isolation, it sure seems like next year Godot could beat Unity in popularity. Or is that so? The problem is that we see these charts and we assume that this is true for the whole industry. While I will get to the part whether Godot in the future is going to become the number one game engine or not, let me take the time to put some things into perspective first. What we've seen just represents the use of Godot in a game jam, leaving no evidence that big studios are adopting Godot just yet, or even thinking about making this step. While Godot has an amazing and enticing zero licensing and zero royalties fee to offer, it will still come down to whether the big companies can make the vision of the games come true with this engine or not, or even if they just believe they can. What the graphs show us though is that new game developers really like to use Godot, and they grow up as game devs using this engine as a starting point. This will leave a mark in the entire career, and maybe some will stick with the Godot engine even forever. Yet it will probably take years for this trend to flood into the higher tiers of development. Big studios will eventually only come around when they see proof in the form of very successful games over and over appearing that the game engine is fit for their use as well. Until then, bigger studios will stick with what works, because a stick to something new could turn out disastrous for the entire studio should a switch not turn out favorably, so it bears a high risk. It is true for the entire world. Bigger companies are not as flexible as smaller companies, and they cannot adapt as quickly. We should also not forget the incident that caused this surge in Godot's exponential increased use, the streaming fee fiasco of Unity. But very recently, Unity finally has pivoted from this idea completely after many heads had rolled, and things seem to go back to square one. Through this, everything seems to go back to normal, and it appears that Unity is ready to take back his share of the pie, right? Well, it's not that simple. What put Godot on the radar in the first place was its solid improvement to the version of Godot 4. Only thanks to this, it was possible for so many developers to switch from Unity to Godot in the first place, so many will have discovered the engine for themselves. Yet, we should not forget that many switched back to Unity shortly after as well. There is a notable trend though. Since many stayed with Godot and never went back to Unity, this incident opened a trend where more and more people talk about the experiences of switching to Godot. So to some degree, it has almost become a given to try Godot out at least once, because many are curious about the experience themselves. Undeniably, Godot got a lot of attention from many places in the past 12 months, and a few crucial areas that previously impeded growth and adoption now show promising improvements. The sudden surge of users also brought a supercharge of new contributors to the engine. And I'm not only speaking of people who help programming the engine, but also people who translate, update, and expand the documentation. And lastly, those who create content of experiences and all kinds of material that lower the barrier of entry to the engine, like me on this channel. Even the legendary Brekkies came back from his exile just to show support for the Godot engine. These things add up more than you'd think. Now take a look at this graph. This graph shows how many contributors the development of the Godot version 4.3 had. And you can also see the increases from each version to another form a trend that is clearly showing that Godot's development is picking up pace, and many bright people come together to form something unique, something awesome. They allow any individual on this planet to make the dream world become a reality through a free-to-use game engine. No restrictions, pure freedom of creativity. This wave has been building for a long time now, and it's almost impossible to stop it now. But the question remains, how far will this wave roll, and will Godot one day become number one engine on the market? I'll tell you what I believe in a second, but generally speaking, it depends on how we measure being number one, and it's almost impossible to answer. Are we considering the number of users as a criteria, or the quantity of games published with the engine? Should it rather be the total revenue, or the games created with an engine rake in, or perhaps only look at the high-end graphical possibilities an engine offers? Is it the sheer size of followers on social media accounts, or assets in an asset store, or learning materials provided by its community? You see, being number one in all of these will be difficult, even if we don't factor in the custom engines of giants like Ubisoft, Nintendo, Square Enix, Capcom, and the list goes on. In my opinion, Godot still has a bright future ahead of it, and I'm already very grateful for it as it is and for it to exist in the first place. I believe Godot can massively grow, up to the point where even 50% of games and more will be created through this engine by solo indies or bigger studios, as long as they stay as they are and keep growing a friendly community as they do. And since Godot's growth and adoption is currently not showing any signs of stopping, on the contrary, I believe that the passion for many has just catched fire and will still burn for a long time, I am looking forward to this future. Will the highest AAA games ever be created in Godot? Nothing is impossible, but it's not very likely in the near future, until big players with big teams adopt Godot as the main engine, or little studios grow into bigger ones while using Godot. Godot has already enabled the creation of thousands of game worlds, and I am sure that more will follow in the future. The fact that this possibility comes totally for free for anyone, with no licensing fees or royalties attached, is already making this engine the number one engine in my eyes. I am excited to see how far Godot will make it in the future, and I'm also already very excited to play all the games that are created with this engine. If you want another reason why Godot is such a good thing and it's a necessity for the whole game engine industry, you might want to watch this video here next. Thank you so much for watching, keep creating awesome games, and see you in the next one.